Welcome to the Best Coast Shire Council Report, your weekly update on council news and events.
Hi, I'm Lauren Grills.
And I'm Steve Fury.
Welcome to this week's show. This week we'll be talking about the tour of Gippsland, Council's win at the MAV Technology Awards. But first, the Business Awards presentation evening was on last Friday. So Steve, let's talk about the winners.
That's right, Lauren. Firstly, we'd like to congratulate everyone who was nominated for awards. But the winner of the 2016 Business of the Year Award is...
Amazing things. This year is the second year in a row that the Phillip Island business has won the Major Judged Award, a fantastic achievement. A huge congratulations to New Haven fresh seafood supplier Bass Strait Direct, who won the People's Choice Award. This is a great effort as they've been operating for less than 12 months.
There were several minor category awards presented, and unfortunately, Lauren, we don't have time to go through all of them, but you can find a list of all the winners on our website at basscoast.vic.gov.au/businessawards. And a big thank you to everyone who entered this year's awards and voted in the People's Choice Awards, and congratulations again to all the winners.
Next up, Council's free public Wi-Fi project was named Collaboration of the Year at the 2016 MAV Technology Awards for Excellence earlier this month.
That's right. The aim of this project was to find a low-cost solution to provide free Wi-Fi in the main town centres across the Shire with minimal ongoing impact on council and business resources. After reviewing a number of possible approaches to this, it was decided to trial using spare internet capacity of local businesses.
Council worked with Waterfront Computers, the Phillip Island Tourism and Business Association and other local businesses, launching the project in time for the summer of 2015-16. With the free Wi-Fi provided in the Cow CBD, as well as the Phillip Island Visitor Information Centre in New Haven.
And the rollout of the NBN will further enhance the service, creating a much higher availability and increasing the performance of the internet during the busy tourism and major event periods. Council's now going to work with business and tourism groups in Inverloch, Wonthaggi and San Remo on future expansion.
The long-awaited draft business case for the Wonthaggi Union Community Arts Centre is now available for your feedback. We mentioned this draft business case was on the way back at the start of August. It contains recommendations and key findings around the needs of our very active arts and cultural community, and in particular, the business case looks at the centre's capacity and future programming needs.
We're holding a community information session on the draft business case, which is on the 31st of August from 5pm to 6:30pm, and it's only appropriate that we hold it at the Wonthaggi Union Arts and Community Centre itself. If you can't make this session, we're also holding an online Q&A session on our Facebook page from 5pm to 6pm on Thursday the 1st of September.
You'll find a copy of the draft business case and a summary report, as well as a link to the feedback survey at basscoast.vic.gov.au/WUCAC. Printed copies are also available from any of our customer service centres. All feedback received before 5pm on Monday the 19th of September will be considered before the final report is presented to Council.
That's terrific. Now, Lauren, the Tour de France finished back in July, but we have good news for cycling fans. The 2016 Australian Paper Tour of Gippsland is coming to Bass Coast with a particularly challenging stage. This race is part of the National Road Series and is considered a jewel in the crown of Australia's domestic road cycling calendar.
Stage 4 will be hosted in Bass Coast on Saturday the 3rd of September and runs a distance of 138 kilometres between Wonthaggi and Inverloch. And for most of us, this is about a 10-minute drive covering 13 kilometres, but I'm guessing they aren't taking a direct route, Steve.
You're right there, Lauren. The race will head for the hills up the Loch Wonthaggi Road with sprints on that road and also through Archie's Creek. Then there are three King of the Mountain sections, one in Glen Forbes and the other two up Mount Misery in the final 40 kilometres of the race. It all starts in Wonthaggi at 10:30am, finishing in a Beckett Street, Inverloch, just outside the Inverloch Hub. If you'd like more information, head to tourofgippsland.com.
And of course, this race will take in some of the most breathtaking scenery in the region, so staying focused on the race may be an extra challenge for some riders. We're out of time this week, but as always, if you have any questions or need more information about anything we've mentioned, give us a call on 1300 B-Coast. That's 1300 226 278 or 03 5671 2211. You can also keep up to date by following us on Facebook, Twitter, YouTube or Instagram, and we'll catch you next week for more council news.
The Best Coast Shire Council Report is broadcast on Tuesday mornings at 9:30, Thursday afternoons at 4:30, and on Saturday mornings at 10 on your community station 3MFM. Audio and transcript is also available from our website, bestcoast.vic.gov.au.